Hello everyone. Today I will explain conversion from regular expression to DFA using syntax tree. In this method, there is no need to convert regular expression to NFA. Instead of that, regular expression can be converted to DFA directly without constructing any intermediate NFA. Let us go through the example. While example, I will explain you few constructs also. Okay, so A union B whole star concatenation, C union D star concatenation, A concatenation, D concatenation, hash. So this is the given regular expression. How to convert this into equivalent DFA using syntax tree, that we will see. Various strings accepted using these regular expressions are ABB, CAD, hash. Here this ABB is accepted using this A union B whole star. C is accepted from this and AD hash. See, this is compulsory part. There is no null string produced in this, and hence each and every accepted string will end with AD hash in this case. Similarly, second, third, so this string is compulsory. The remaining portion before this string can be generated using this two concatenation. Now let us see how to construct syntax tree from this. So for construction of syntax tree, concentrate on concatenations. So if you see the rule, first this concatenation is evaluated, applied, then second concatenation is applied, then third concatenation, and then fourth concatenation is applied. Now to apply this concatenation, we require result of A union B whole star, and we also require result of C union D star. So this is the left hand side string of concatenation, and this is the right hand side string of this first concatenation. So first let us construct the tree for this. So I will construct a node of concatenation. Now on left side of this node, we require the result of A union B whole star. Now if we see the precedence, due to brackets, union has higher precedence in this case as compared to clean closure. Okay, so first construct a tree of union. Now union is a binary operator, so it requires two child nodes. So construct a node of union, and it has two operands A and B. Fine, this is A union B. Next is clean closure on this, so construct a node of clean closure. So this indicates A union B whole star. After A union B whole star, next is we have to apply concatenation on it. So that previous concatenation node is this. Now this is left side of concatenation node. What about right string of concatenation? That is C union D star. So on right hand side, again, now this union and concatenation, so star here clean closure has higher precedence as compared to union. So first construct a node of D star. Fine, this is in union with C. So take a union operator, right hand side is D star and left hand side is node C. And if you observe, this subtree is nothing but right hand side string of concatenation. So this tree is up to this string A union B whole star concatenation, C union D whole star. Now after completion of first, construct a node of second concatenation. Fine, now what is left hand side of this concatenation? The string produced by this regular expression. So this will become left child node of second concatenation. Its right child node is string A. Now next, third concatenation, its left hand side is answer of this entire string and its right hand side is D. And last concatenation, its left hand side is string produced from this to this, and right hand side is hash. So equivalent syntax tree for given regular expression. Now, once the syntax tree is constructed, we have to find first position of each and every symbol in given regular expression. Here, for that, first give the numbering to each and every symbol. First symbol is given number 1, second symbol is given number 2, number 3, 4, 5, 6, and hash is given number 7. Here you can see there are two symbols having a name, but still they are given the different numbers. Okay. Now, how to construct or how to find first position of each and every node? So, second step is, after constructing the syntax tree, we will find first position of each and every node. So, first position of any node having symbol is always the symbol itself. So, here this is symbol number 1, this is symbol number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Here you can observe all the leaf nodes contain the symbols and all the non-leaf nodes contain the operators. That is the beauty of syntax tree. All the leaf nodes are always having symbols and all the non-leaf nodes are having operators. Okay. So, after given the symbol number, now observe this union. So, to find the symbol, which symbol can occur at first position of union, there are few rules to find the first position. If it is a simple symbol, then the symbol itself will come at first position. If it is a union, say A union B, then any symbol can come at first position. The string can begin with 1 or the string can begin with 2 also. And hence, this union has symbols 1 or 2 both at first position. Now, to find first position of clean's closure. Okay, so it is A union B whole star. So, to find first position of clean's closure, it is always first position of its child node. For any clean's closure, its first position is first position of child node. So, here also 1 and 2. Similarly, this here we have symbol 3. This is a clean's closure. So, again it has its child node as first position. This is union. So, either symbol 3 can come at first position or symbol 4 can come at first position of union. Next is concatenation. We have to start this from leaf node to root node. Now, for concatenation, we have to refer the rules of nullable. What do you mean by nullable? If any string is producing null symbol or producing null string, then it is called nullable string. For example, A union B whole star, it gives a null string and hence it is nullable. So, if we observe the nodes A union B, this union is not nullable. However, the union can be nullable if we take some string like this, A union B whole star. Then, for example, here, if I select D star and then select null string, then this union node can be nullable. So, for union node or for OR node, if any one of child node is nullable, then that union node can also be nullable. That is the rule for union. If any of the child node is null, then for concatenation, as we know, if there is a concatenation, A concatenation B, then always all the strings will begin with A. So, in this case, first symbol is not nullable and hence all the string will begin with A only. But what if I take A star B? This is also concatenation, but left hand side string is nullable and hence all the strings can also begin with B. Okay, so for concatenation, the rule is first position of cat node is first position of left node. Here L is its left hand child node. Okay, so it is always first position of left node. But if this is first position, now if L is nullable, that is if left hand child produces the null string, then first position is also first pose of its right child. Okay, again let us see through the example. A star B hash, then first position of this cat node is first position of A. L is left hand side node here. So first position of L is A. Now check if this gives null string. Yes, A star is giving null string, and hence if L is nullable, if condition is true, if it is yes, then you have to include first position of right also. So here I will include B also. So A and B, both symbols can come at first position of this concatenation. Okay, so likewise we can find for concatenation this left hand side node is nullable because it is clean's closure. It always gives a null string, and hence we have to include right side also. So first position of this tree is 1, 2, and this is nullable, and hence also 3, 4. Okay, now this concatenation refer its left hand side, still it is nullable. The reason is symbol 1, 2, it is clean's closure, so it is always nullable. Now if I select D star from union, then D star can also give null string, and hence this cat node is also nullable. So for this concatenation, again same rule, include left hand side symbols, and if left hand side symbol is nullable, then we have to include right side symbol also. So for second concatenation, you can see 1, 2, 3, 4 and even 5th symbol can come at first position. Now next concatenation, its left hand side is always included 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. But it's now check, this left hand side is not nullable because at least symbol A is present. This right child is not nullable for this concatenation, and hence this cat node is nullable, but this for left hand side of this cut node is not nullable. It contains at least 5th symbol, and hence 6th symbol can never come at first position of this concatenation. Last one, again 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, because its left string is not nullable. Fine, so this concatenation node is nullable, while this concatenation node is not nullable. Okay, and hence here we will not include symbol number 6. Now to apply syntax tree method, first thing is we have to find first position of root, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 in this example. And then we have to find follow position of each and every symbol. Follow position means which symbols can follow the current input symbol. So if say follow pose of 1, then we have to find which symbols can follow symbol number 1. So here if you see, this is clean's closure, so 1 itself can follow it, or symbol 2 can follow it, because it is clean's closure. So either it is AAB or it is ABB also. So first and second symbol both can follow it. Now if I select null for this, then symbol 3 can also follow, like ACAD hash. So third symbol include it. Now fourth symbol can also follow it if from this union I select D star. For example, the strings ABAD hash. So fourth symbol can also follow it. Now if you observe this 3 and 4 symbol, out of this I am selecting D star, and if I replace D star with null, then fifth symbol can also follow first symbol. For example, the string A again from this star null, and hence AAD hash, this is acceptable. So fifth symbol can also follow first symbol. Okay, sixth can never follow it. Similarly, follow position of 2 is also same. It can be followed by symbol 1, 2, 3, 4 or 5. Follow position of 3 is, if I select symbol number 3, then I will never select 4 because this is union. So follow pose of 3 is 5. Then follow pose of 4, as it is clean's closure, so follow pose of 4 is 4 itself or 5. It is clean's closure, so D can be followed by T or it can be followed by symbol number 5. Then follow pose of symbol 5 is only single symbol 6. Follow pose of 6 is 7. And follow pose of 7 is hash. No symbol will follow symbol number 7. So this is how you can find first position of root and follow position of each and every symbol. Now first, after calculation of this, we can apply the method to construct the states of DFA. First position of root will give me a new state A, and this will be start state of DFA. Then take one by one all the symbols from A and construct the new states of DFA. So take follow position of 1, follow position of 2, follow position of 3 and so on. But while considering follow position, observe that symbol 1 and 5, they are having same input symbol A. And hence we will take their union. So take follow position of 1, union follow position of 5 to construct the next state of DFA. So this will give 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 and a new state B. Then after considering 1 and 5, take follow position of 2, 3 and 4. All of them are different symbols, so take their follow positions independently. Follow position of 2 is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. That is nothing but state A itself. Then follow position of 3 is 5. That will give a new state C, and follow position of 4 is 4 and 5, so that will give a new state D. After completion of all the symbols from state A, now take state B and repeat the process. That is, take follow position of all the symbols to construct new states of DFA. Again here symbol A 1 and symbol 5 are same input symbol A, and symbol 4 and 6, they are same input symbol D, so we will take their union. So first follow position of 1, union follow position of 5, that will give a state B again. So if current state is B and input symbol is A, then it remains in the same state B. Then take follow position of 2, so it will give state A. Take follow position of 3, take all the symbols from B. So follow position of 3, it will give state C. Follow position of 4, as I said, 4 and 6, they are same input symbol D. So take follow position of 4, union follow position of 6, that is 4, 5 and 7. And hence it is a new state E. After completion of B, repeat the steps for C. So for C, we have only one input symbol in C, 5. So take follow position of 5, that is 6. So this is again a new state F. Okay. Now let us construct a DFA for states A, B, C. Then we will continue with the remaining states. So for A, its input symbols are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now if current state is A and input symbol is 1, that is when current state is A and input symbol is 2, that is B, it is going to state A, means it remains in the same state on input symbol B. Then from state A on input symbol 3, that is C, it is going to state C. From A on input symbol 4, that is D, it is going to state D. In B, we have symbols 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. State C, it has symbol 5. And state D contains symbols 4 and 5. Then from state B, on input symbol 1 and 5, that is A, it remains in the same state. Then from B, on input symbol small b, it is going to state A. Then on symbol C, it is going to state C, and on input symbol D, that is 4 and 6, it is going to state E. From B, on input symbol D, it is going to state E. Then from C, on input symbol 5, that is A, it is going to state F. In state E, we have symbols 4, 5, 7, and in state F, we have symbol 6. So, after completion of A, B, and C, now repeat the steps for remaining states D, E, and F. So, in state D, we have symbol 4 and 5. So, follow position of 4 and follow position of 5. So, follow position of 4 is 4 and 5. That is nothing but state D itself. And follow position 5 is 6. That is state F. Now, from E, we have 4, 5 and 7. So, follow position of 4 is 4 and 5, that is state D. Then follow position of 5 is 6, that is state F. And follow position of 7 is 5. So this will give a new state G, and state G will become accepting state. The state that we are getting on follow position of hash, that will give a new state G. After E, we'll take F. In F, symbol 6, so follow position of 6 is 7, that is a new state H. And at the end, G is 5, so we will take H, follow position. In H, we have symbol 7, follow position of 7 is 5, so again state G, an accepting state. So let us construct the remaining DFA. If current state is D and input symbol is 4, that is D, it remains in the same state. Then, if state is D and input symbol is 5, that is A, it is going to state F. From E, on input symbol 4, that is D, it is going to state D. This A is here, and on this arrow we have D. From E on input symbol A, it is going to state F. From E on hash, it is going to a new state G, that is nothing but an accepting state. Then from F on input symbol 6, that is D, it goes to state H. And from H on hash, it is going to accepting state. So, this is nothing but the equivalent diagram for given regular expression. Thank you.